Dzień dobry dla wszystkich, bardzo serdecznie w kolejnym odcinku zagrajmy w Fallout New Vegas. Wygląda na to, że pora instalacji gry, wywalenie wszystkich modyfikacji DLC będą działać. Bo mamy tu pełny team, kolesi. Ricky?
You looking for trouble, bud? I got plenty to spare, so watch your ass around me.
Nieuzasadniona wrogość i nadpobudliwość. Od jak dawna jesteś uzależniony od Psycho?
Hey, fuck you! I didn't say nothing about using Psycho!
A ile Psycho ma odłożone na czarną godzinę? Jeśli na straku skończą się zapasy, bycie na głodzie nie jest
God damn it! I didn't say nothing about using Psycho.
przyjemne.
But just talking hypno-theoretically here, got any suggestions?
Mogę ci sprzedać dawkę sprycę, taniej nie będzie.
Fixer. Never said I wanted to kick the habit. Guess I can use it when I run out of the good stuff. How much?
80 kapsli.
That much for a dose? Fucking robbery. All right, here's your money. Don't spend it all in one place.
Ojej, oj, robisz tu coś pożytecznego poza ględzeniem?
You want to know what I do, bud? Anything I fucking want. I'm one of a kind. I've been places, see? And done things. Lots of them. And when it's time to kill shit up, hell yeah, I'm a fucking storm of death. Something or someone make the mistake of crossing Ricky? I'll fucking dead-eye him, her, or it. In fact, that's my nickname. Dead-eye Ricky. That's my name.
Martwe oko, skąd to przezwisko?
How you think? I shoot things in the eye. That's how good I am. Yeah, I'm that good. Why, once I got jumped by three Death Jaws. Except actually one
Szpony
was
śmierci,
a
idioto,
man's,
nawet nie wiesz, jak to się
but I
mówi.
didn't panic because I never panic. What I did was really
Jakbyś ujrzał
stupid.
prawdziwego szpona
Yeah, he
śmierci, to
was
byś się
smart.
zesrał.
Pop in the eye.
Szczęki śmierci, a może raczej szpony śmierci.
No, you heard me right. Death Jaws. They're like death claws, but bigger teeth. Or there was the time one of them Steel Brotherhood assholes made the mistake of messing with me. Last mistake he ever made.
Twierdzisz, że Paladyn Bractwa Stali zginął z twojej ręki?
What's it sound like I'm saying? If I was saying what you said I was saying, then yeah, I said it. I was walking along, minding my own, and up pops one of them Brotherhoods. He yells, "Hand over that laser rifle, asshole!" So I hand it over, just to make him think I'm scared. But really, I'm not. I never am. Before he knows what hit him, I draw my 11-millimeter machine gun and bam, bam, right through the eye slit in his helmet. DOA.
Co za bzdura! Hełm pancerza wspomaganego serii T jest kuloodporny.
Then I guess this dumb fucker's armor must have been
Co
decent
za
after all.
idiota!
All I know is he died up real dead when I killed him, okay?
Jakieś inne specjalne zdolności, umiejętności?
Well, I grew up near Dayglo out west, so yeah, I grew a third nut that glows in the dark.
Widzę, że nosisz Pip-Boya i kombinezon krypty.
Nice job, Eagle Eye. Of course I got a pit boy and a vault suit. So what?
Skąd masz kombinezon krypty?
Where the fuck you think? Vault 22. That's where I grew up.
Kłamiesz. Wiem, że w Krypcie 22 od 150 lat nikt nie mieszka.
Oh, you've been to Vault 22, huh? I may have been exaggerating a little. Truth is, I got this suit and the pit boy off a dead prospector who came out from Zion. Guy was dead when I found him, okay? Had a ton of shit on him. That's how I know there's good loot in Zion, see?
Do czego używasz Pip-Boya?
Sorry,
The shit I do with it is so far over your head, be wasting my time to put it in words you could understand. Basically, it makes me badass. More badass, I mean. It's totally mind-blowing shit. It ain't just some bracelet. Know what I mean? Jed says it's got masked shit like that. So that's how I'm gonna guide this caravan where it needs to go. Not that I didn't know all that already.
Dotarło do ciebie, że ja też mam P-Boya?
Huh? Of course I noticed. First thing I noticed about you. Me? I'm so used to wearing mine, it's just normal. Don't think you're someone special just because you got one.
Twój P-Boy nie działa. Ekran jest zablokowany i brakuje przycisku ponownego uruchomienia.
Bullshit! Ain't nothing wrong with my Pip-Boy. I mean, Pip-Boy. Look, this is a sweet gig for me. Don't go fucking it up. What are you after anyways?
Spieprzaj o to, czego chcę. Nie potrzebujemy cię.
Fine. You win, asshole. Enjoy leading the expedition into a fucking ambush. Hope you all die.
Spierdzielaj. Ogólnie, bo... zginiesz, jak tam się władujesz, więc nie chcę cię tu widzieć, na pewno. Stella, mogę z tobą pogadać?
Looking to join this caravan, huh? Look to me like you can handle yourself.
Co tutaj robisz?
Earning my keep. Jed hired me on as a caravan guard for this expedition of his. The work suits me. I've tried staying put in one place, but it never works out. Grew up in New Reno, and I couldn't put that snake tooth behind me fast enough. Then I wound up wasting the prime of my life playing sheriff in Caliente. Little town north on the 93. Talk about a pain in the ass. You ask me, best to keep moving. At least the scenery changes.
O, jak to jest dorastać w Nowym Reno?
Imagine New Vegas if there was no Mr. House type fella keeping the peace. Then give everybody a gun and a jet addiction. Town's run by a bunch of crime families. No law to speak of. Make trouble and you wind up buried in Golgotha outside town. The scuzz factor's off the charts. Non-stop whoring and drugs. Couldn't walk down the street without getting asked to star in a porn movie. So I got my ass out of there while I still owned it. Guess I figured the answer to every problem was rule of law. Naive, huh?
Opowiedz mi o Caliente.
Place lived up to its name, that's for sure. When you got fresh water and a trickle of geothermic power, always be some gang of assholes wants to kill you for it. Spent more years and took more bullets than I care to admit protecting that hellhole from dangers within and without. If it wasn't the 80s or the White Legs raiding, it was someone from town drunk off his ass trying to win an argument with a shotgun. Got tired of shooting the folks I was supposed to protect. So, now I do this.
80-tki to gang czy plemię?
What's the difference? Raiders is raiders. Bunch of them swept into town and dragged off two working girls. Deputies and me gave pursuit straight into 80s territory. By the time we caught up with the girls, there wasn't much left of them, so we turned for home. Made it back to Caliente without further losses, but we was watched the whole way. Never seen so few people cover so much land. Goddamn creepy. If the 80s had wanted to kill us, we would have been dead. Guess they figured we weren't worth the trouble.
Co wiesz o plemieniu białych nóg?
Used to be they raided northeast of Caliente time to time. But then the Desert Rangers fell apart 10 years ago, absorbed into the NCR. Soon enough, the White Legs were swarming all over that stretch of I-15. Folks learned not to head north if they wanted to keep their scalps. Eventually, the White Legs destroyed the bridges across the Virgin River over in Arizona. End of discussion.
Do widzenia.
Catch you another time, then.
Dobra, jednego gościa wkurzyliśmy, przekoniliśmy. Z tą pogadaliśmy, teraz z tobą.
Howdy, friend. Heard my little broadcast, did you? Yeah, you look the type. Damn good thing you came along, too. We had another prospect with a pit boy, but he done skedaddled. Something must have spooked the boy. Wait a minute, I recognize you. Yeah, you're Alice McLafferty's rising star, ain't you? You sure you want to be here? McLafferty's non-competes are pretty rigid.
Dawno mnie nie było w Utah. Co się tam teraz dzieje?
Well, it ain't good, I'll tell you that. It's not like the Mojave or the NCR. Hell, even Arizona under Caesar is safer. You got raiders all over the damn place. Tribes of degenerates that'll eat you as soon as look at you. Regional warlords, the works. Not too many decent places to stop and trade. New Canaan's one of the only ones left I know about.
Opowiedz mi o bandytach.
They're about what you'd expect. Crazy, jacked up on Kims, violent as hell, and not too bright. The worst of the 80s, but we won't be passing through their turf on this run.
Zdegenerowane plemiona?
That's right. The folks that lived in Zion before the war, they didn't just get a little savage. They're downright feral. Most of them don't even speak English anymore. You got to get yourself a new Canaanite translator to talk to them. The ones you really got to watch out for are the White Legs from the Great Salt Lake. They'll attack just about anyone that ain't one of theirs.
Bataskowie, jak bardzo niebezpieczni.
Dangerous enough we won't be going near them if we can help it. I got no desire for my head to decorate some little gas station for its walls, thanks.
Mam jeszcze parę pytań.
Shoot.
Rozumiem, że taką karawanę mywę do Syjonu. Co wiesz o tym obszarze?
Well, I ain't never been inside myself. Did some trading with the new Canaanites from their mission there. But that was all on the outskirts. All the old ways in and out were destroyed after the war. But we got ourselves the location of a pass the new Canaanites use. That's our way in. That's why I wanted someone with a Pip-Boy on the caravan. The map will be helpful for checking the topography, keeping us on the trail.
Opowiedz mi o kompanii karawanowej Radosne Flaki.
We're a smaller company out of Sacktown, up in the northern part of the NCR. We run some business through New Reno. They're on the Little Loop. Had a nice run to Salt Lake City, too, but then we lost contact with New Canaan, and that went all to hell.
Wygląda na to, że kondycja finansowa Radosnych Flaków nie jest zbyt dobra.
You ain't wrong. Losing the Salt Lake City run really stung us. If we can't re-establish contact with this run, we'll be in real trouble.
Dlaczego nie możecie dostać się do Salt Lake City?
Without New Canaan's mission in Zion, the only ways to Salt Lake City are down the old I-80, or up through Ogden. The highway's too risky. NCR's rangers are so busy here in the Mojave, they don't have the manpower to keep the raiders off. Ogden's just too far. We'd lose more in travel expenses than we'd ever earn.
Co możesz mi powiedzieć o Nowym Kanaanie?
Don't know much about the place, but I can tell you about the people. The new Canaanites were some kind of religious group from before the war. They control the old city of Ogden, a ways north of Zion, and they got themselves a nice defensible mission in the canyon itself. Or they did. They trade a fair bit with the tribes in Zion. Well, the ones that don't try to kill them anyways.
Wiesz coś o ich religii?
I ain't a praying man myself. They paid for their goods and dealt square with us. That's all I ever cared about. But don't think that just because they're religious, that they're pacifists. They take care of their own, and they're damn fine marksmen, too.
Nie wiesz, co się stało z ich misją?
Nope. Hence this caravan. If we don't make contact with the new Canaanites, Happy Trails might as well just shrivel up and die.
Mam jeszcze parę pytań. Opowiedz mi o zadaniu.
The job is simple. Help us get this caravan into Zion. Find New Canaan. The pay is 25 caps per day, half up front, half on return. You'll get a bonus if we make it into Zion, plus another bonus if we reach New Canaan. Oh, one more thing. Don't mention the name Joshua Graham to anyone. Anyone.
Kim jest Joshua Graham i dlaczego mam o nim nie mówić?
Just don't. It makes the New Canaanites powerful uncomfortable. And it scares the britches off the tribals. Don't talk about the burned man either while you're at it. Trust me on this one. It's for your own good.
Dobra, możemy wyruszać.
are you now? You know we ain't coming back this way for a good long while now, right? And you know about the weight limit. I don't want no whining about old Mr. Masterson. I left my one-of-a-kind plasma cannon back at base. Can we go back for it? You sure you're ready now?
Uniosę nie tylko swój pfen, ale i twój i jego jeszcze ten z grzbietu braminów.
I do believe you could.
Skąd ten limit obciążenia?
You ain't never been to Zion, have you? We'll be passing through a whole mess of narrow slot canyons and high rough passes. A big pack will get you wedged in like a super mutant crawling through a storm drain, and too much weight will kill you in the thin air.
Możemy wyruszać do Syjonu.
You sure about that this time? We ain't coming back for a while.
Tak, na pewno.
Well, all right then. Let's get moving. We got a long road ahead of us.
Okej, okay. I ja się wcześniej, moi drodzy, odciążyłem, żeby się przygotować na to. Wziąłem sobie tylko kilka broni, najlepszy pancerz wspomagany, no bo... Spoko.
Folks in the NCR started to hear about a community in northern Utah called New Canaan. Didn't know much about them, except that they were religious folks, sent out missionaries to talk to the tribes. We've seen our share of cults, but the New Canaanites, they were honest traders. Good fighters, too. Raiders wouldn't tangle with them. But then, the Legion appeared in Arizona. I reckon you know all about them. Turns out Caesar's first war chief, the Malpais Legate, was a New Canaanite, Joshua Graham. Legend goes that Graham was the meanest, toughest son of a bitch in the whole damn Legion. The New Canaanites wouldn't talk about him. They were ashamed. Guess I can't blame them. Well, at Hoover Dam, the Malpais Legate finally met his match. Hanlon and Oliver kicked his New Canaanite butt right back over the river. Caesar had to make an example for the others, to show them that even at the highest level, failure wouldn't be tolerated. He had Graham covered in pitch, lit on fire, and thrown into the Grand Canyon. People say he didn't even scream on the way down. Not long after, some of the slaves and tribal started to talk, said Graham wasn't dead. Shouldn't have been any surprise. All this talk bothered Caesar, so he forbade anyone from speaking his name. Wanted to erase Joshua Graham from history. He got his wish. Joshua Graham disappeared, and in his place came legends of the burned man walking the wastes. Probably just a tribal ghost story, but New Canaan's been silent for a long time. Maybe it's a coincidence. Maybe the Malpais Legate is dead. Or maybe Joshua Graham did crawl out of that canyon and finally found his way back home.
Okej, więc zerknijcie, moi drodzy.
But here we are, Zion. I know your feet hurt. I know you're tired. But I need everyone's mind on the trail ahead.
Ain't the trail ahead worries me, Jed. Those descents we made through that slot canyon back up there. Ain't no way we're getting back out the way we come. And then what?
God damn it, Stella heard you the first time. And the 15th, too. The New Canaanites will know a way. And if they don't, we've got the maps on our friend's Pip-Boy over there. Enough lollygagging. Get moving. And keep an eye out for tribals.
Sorry to bother you.
A, moi drodzy, jeżeli chodzi o uzbrojenie, no to więc tutaj macie wszystkie punkty na mapie z tego naszego tego. Więc oczywiście wszystkie będę chciał zwiedzić, no bo jakby by inaczej. I mam tutaj ten super specjalny karabin. Czyli to. Mam też bziu, czyli pistolet laserowy, mam karabin myśliwski, I pistolet maszynowy 12,7. Więcej broni nie uznałem, że nie potrzebuję. Czyli wziąłem te broni, do których mam dużo amunicji. I pancerz wspomagany, który daje mi określone boosty i bonusy. Dobra, więc zmienimy sobie broń na naszego ICS-a. Bum. Aj, widzę, że sprawdzi, rozwalacie. Dobra, poczekajmy, aż się zatrzyma. Dzień dobry, bum. I co, tu jest jeszcze jakiś? Nie, tu był jakiś. Oj, chyba wszyscy zginęli. Mistrz bólu z białych nóg. Miałeś pistolet na synowi 9 mm. 3 tomahawki. Sporo warte, więc sobie wezmę. Miałeś toporek strawacki, również sporo warty. Miałeś naboje i pistolet maszynowy. Notabene będę musiał i strój brzemienia białych nóg. Bezwartościowy. Ty, co miałeś? Kapsle, naboje, odlot, odtrutka, 110 mm mało warty i steampack sobie wezmę. Ty, dziecinko, co miałaś? Karabin myśliwski będzie do naprawy mojego, jakby się popsuł. Ty, kolego, co miałeś? Karabin laserowy. Zepsuty, recharger, nawet w dość niezłym stanie. Czyli steampacki, recharger sobie wezmę. Akurat mogę się przydać. Ty miałeś karabin myśliwski kolejny. A tutaj była wyrzutnia granatu, nawet w dość niezłym stanie. Weźmiemy sobie. Tak samo granat ułamkowy i granat 40 mm. Pancerz skórzany brałem niepotrzebnie. Dobra, to sobie od razu możemy zreperować. I weźmy sobie, powiedzmy, karabin myśliwski, bo mamy akurat możliwość reparacji. I buwowy dowód z białych nóg właśnie idzie spać. Mieć karabin na jelenie. I amunicję do tego i kolejny pistolet maszynowy 9 mm. Pręt zbrojeniowy jest warty tylko 500 na maksymalnym ulepszeniu, więc nie opłaca mi się. Ty miałeś też karabin na jelenie. Pręt zbrojeniowy, który mi się nie opłaca. Brać, jeżeli chodzi o sprzęt, karabin na jelenie. Bym sobie naprawił, nawet być może bym sobie zmienił, bo mam do niego troszkę amunicji, którą mimo wszystko chciałbym wykorzystać na coś. Dobra, ciebie najpierw. A potem ciebie. Miałeś strzelbę taktyczną, czyli oni mają już tutaj niezłe bronie, praktycznie najlepsze, jakie tylko mogą być. Bo strzelba taktyczna to jest jedna z najlepszych broni w grze, więc... Wow! Panowie, widzę, że wyście się nieźle wyekwipowali. Nie dziwię się, że was tutaj tak nie lubią. Ja sam bym was bardzo mocno nie lubił. O, ktoś pomógł nam. Dobra, 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 ktoś nam pomógł.
Hoi, white legs don't leave survivors often. You're some kind of lucky, let me tell you. You came from outside, didn't you? From the civilized lands. Wow, Joshua will want to hear about this.
Cywilizowane krainy? Co masz na myśli?
I mean the lands beyond the valley. The place where the cities never fell. Where people don't live in tribes and forage just to survive. Joshua keeps saying it isn't paradise out there. But how can it not be, compared to this? Sorry, I'm getting distracted. Joshua will want to know about you. Please, go to our camp on the Eastern Virgin. Tell him how you came to be here.
Masz ciekawe wyobrażenie na temat Mojave, ale pójdę z tobą do twojego szefa.
Good sisters. Maybe while you're there, you can tell me about where you came from. Yeah.
Dobra, zatem zyskaliśmy towarzysza i de facto załatwiliśmy to tak, jak powinno być załatwione. Notabene w pełnym słońcu, w takiej zbroi, notabene mamy wentylatory na plecach i bardzo dobrze, żebyśmy się ugotowali. Pogadajmy.
What can I tell you?
Opowiedz mi o okolicy. Są tu jakieś ciekawe okazje dzikiej przyrody?
Mostly it's the mountain bighorners. Whole herd of them up on the cliffs there. Usually they're not too aggressive, but lately, whew. My guess is one of the calves got lost somewhere along the way. Bighorners are communal. One missing calf, and the whole herd gets ornery. If that calf doesn't turn up soon, they might very well come down into the valley and attack the camp.
Może ja w czymś pomogę.
Yeah? Hey, thanks. Most of the hunters don't listen when I tell them the problem. Just one thing. Try not to kill any bighorners if you can, yeah? You'll drive the herd off and we'll have to range farther on our hunts.
A co w takim razie radził mi zrobić?
You might try luring the baby out with some banana yucca. These bighorners go crazy for the stuff.
Dobrze, zajmę się tym.
That's great. I'll help any way I can.
Dane zadania. Krętorogi nad... I coś tam. Znajdź sposób... O. I to mamy nieco dalej. Chodź. Jeszcze coś tutaj jest do pogadania?
What can I tell you?
Kto mnie zaatakował?
White legs. Nasty bunch. They've been raiding deeper into Zion ever since New Canaan was wiped out.
Co, nowy Kanon został zniszczony? Jak to?
That's what Joshua said. White legs came down from Great Salt Lake in force. Fell on New Canaan before they could mount a defense. Joshua found some of the survivors led by a man named Daniel. Most of them have fled the valley. But Daniel stayed on with the Sorrows tribe. He and Joshua have been arguing over whether to stand and fight the White Legs, or take the Sorrows and the Dead Horses out of the valley.
Skąd się tu wzięli?
That's the weird part. Normally, the White Legs keep to the Great Salt Lake. I don't know what brought them down this far south.
Chcę się dowiedzieć o tobie czegoś więcej.
What can I tell you?
Czemu walka z plemieniem białych nóg jest taka ważna?
Well, because there are enemies. What else would we do? They take our land, they kill our scouts, they poach our hunting grounds.
Do czego służą te łuski na Maczudze?
We decorate our clubs with them to honor Joshua Graham. They were the weapons of his old tribe, so now they are ours. Can't say they seem that dangerous to me, but Joshua says they won the West.
Co wiesz o Nowokananejczykach?
Little bit. I met some of their missionaries a few times. But I've never been to their city. Joshua could tell you more. Or Daniel, I imagine.
Co Joshua dla ciebie zrobił?
If it wasn't for Joshua, the dead horses would still be the whipping boys of the Zion Valley. He taught us how to hold our territory, to protect ourselves. He guided us away from Kaisar, and showed us how Kaisar would have destroyed us.
Pamiętasz, doszło w czasu, gdy nie był jeszcze waszym przywódcą?
only a little. I was very young. He was different. Prouder, yes, but harder, crueler, more driven. Really, I was terrified of him. We all were. When he came back, I almost didn't believe he was the same man. He was humbler. He wanted to protect, not destroy.
Opowiedz mi o waszym plemieniu.
We came up in the land of the dead horse. Though, why the Bakwen folks called it that, I got no hint. We raided. We fought. We lost. Our enemies drove us back into Zion, and we would have died if it hadn't been for Joshua. Joshua and his Kaisar.
Czekaj, a co z Cezarem?
When Joshua first came to us, he was servant to a man he called Kaisar. He led his master's armies, and we were ready to follow him into war. Then he lost his master's army to a tribe called Enciar, the Sunset People. When he returned, he was as you saw him, burned, broken, but changed. He led us away from Kaisar, led us to our own destiny in Zion.
Co to za tatuaże?
Dead horses mark ourselves to commemorate our hunts. When a hunter takes a great beast, or when a youth goes on his first hunt, he gets a tattoo.
Dlaczego nazywają cię idący po śladach?
Our advanced scouts leave chalk signs to mark places rich with game. I'm not a full scout yet, so I follow the marks and guide the hunters.
Nie mam więcej pytań, porozmawiajmy o czymś innym. Opowiedz mi coś więcej na temat Joshua Grahama.
He's been the chief of our tribe since he came back to the valley. He went off to the civilized world years ago to fight a war. That didn't go well.
Ostatnia wojna, o której wiem, to atak Legionu Cezara na zaporę Hoovera. To tam walczył?
I don't know. He doesn't talk about it much. Maybe. But how can two civilized tribes fight over something as small as a dam?